With the holidays just a few weeks away and international travel still sluggish, many who have been cooped up in their homes for months are looking at staycations. Are our hotels ready for the rush? Are Filipinos ready to go out there? This morning we speak with Miguel Capistrano, the country manager of Red Doorz, a Singapore-based hotel operator. Hi, Miguel. Good morning.
Good morning, Mimi. It's a windy morning.
I know. I hope you're in a safe place. But okay, so let's go right down to it. Give us a sense of how much business has returned, Miguel, with a lot of economies already starting to opening up.
Yes, since the government already allowed 100% operations of hotels in the Philippines, and since around 2 months ago, the local economy and the loosening of the quarantine actually has helped bring in room nights for the hotels of the Philippines, and for Red Doorz in particular, we've been really getting month-on-month increase in terms of our pickups. So it's really looking positive.
Mm-hmm. When you say month-on-month increase in pickup, what sort of occupancy rate are we talking about?
So we of course, around March and April, it was down, right? So towards May, June, July, we've been picking up like 30% increase every month. We have been averaging around 70% occupancy, which is not bad in certain months. So that's actually a good sign that business is really picking up.
Okay. It's been, 5 years since Red Doorz opened the first branch in Indonesia. And now it's in Singapore, Manila, of course, and Vietnam, with over 1,000 properties. Which markets would you say are ahead when it comes to recovery from the pandemic crisis, and which are lagging behind? Are you seeing green shoots in the local market now compared to the others?
Well, Indonesia is has been very good in controlling their cases compared to the Philippines. Philippines is still, unfortunately, in the highest, top 20. Singapore, better. Vietnam, better. But what I see is, as we progress, like the Philippines opening the economy, certainly domestic market will be the leader, no? the ones that we should tap. Even if it's like open ready for travel globally, people will still be wary to travel right away. So I believe the domestic market, and given our population and given our 7,107 islands to choose from, domestic travel really be boom.
And do you think that this push for staycation among locals will be enough, the bump will be enough to at least compensate for the absence of foreign travel?
Well, this is the first time this has happened, but I believe Philippines, compared to like Singapore, is actually highly domestic. So we have, as I mentioned, we have a lot of destinations that I think the Filipinos for now will choose to go to, as instead of going to Hong Kong, Europe, or America for the meantime. So yes.
Okay, you know, having people gather in a single location like hotels, one can't help but worry about, you know, super spreaders. How are you using Hygiene Pass? I know that you have a certain Hygiene Pass to boost confidence of your hotel goers.
So, unlike before, today, more importantly, people would like to travel based on sanitation. The hotels they choose from, aside from rate and amenities, first and foremost, the safety. So we have been the leader. We started it earlier than most hotels in the Philippines, even in Indonesia, the Hygiene Pass certification, wherein we got the services and guidance of a licensed doctor, Dr. Lorenzo Pinto from Harvard, who's a Filipino, to audit and implement using our systems and technology for the hotels to really operate in a safe and clean manner so that their guests will be assured of safety during their stay, and as well, most importantly, their workers as well.
But aside from, you know, sanitation, the guarantee of being sanitized, these hotels, have you had to drop your prices just to be able to entice people to visit your hotels?
Well, we operate in a dynamic pricing mode. So, based on occupancy. So, as I mentioned, we've been getting really good occupancy. But in times that there are really lean occupancies, of course, our prices will drop. But in general, I think most hotels currently in the tourism industry are trying to review their prices in a way that would let the Filipino afford the staycation even during this time.
You know, countries are beginning to talk about travel bubbles. Essentially, these are travel alliances between countries with low infection rates to allow travelers from those countries to freely visit. What are you hearing on the local front? I mean, we're watching closely the Singapore-Hong Kong bubble right now. Do you think that could also work? And basing from your experience pre-pandemic, how many percent would you say is accounted for by foreign travelers versus local? Just for context.
Well, in June, ASEAN actually started talking to the ASEAN nations regarding a travel bubble. Mm-hmm. But as you know, as we all know, not all countries are able to implement or lessen their cases the same way, right? Mm-hmm. So it really depends on the performance or the way each country is able to manage the cases that would allow a more free travel bubble. In terms of foreign travel, the government right now is allowing essential travel and to some extent some travels that can be approved per industry mm-hmm. into the Philippines. Okay. So right, whereas before there was like 40% foreign
Miguel
travelers, right now it's just hello.
Yes. So can from 40%, where are you? Okay, from 40%.
So it has lessened. So 10 to 15% foreign travel allowed only for essentials and also for special cases. But as we progress towards controlling the cases and even the numbers will go back.
Okay, on that note, Miguel, thank you so much for joining us. Please stay safe and good luck
you
in your programs for Red Doorz.
Thank you.